Welcome back to my channel. My name is Vanessa if you are new here. If you are new here, hi, hello, how are you doing? If you haven't seen any of my other apartment related videos, I'm coming at you with another apartment video. I am all moved into my apartment. I recently moved in. Actually, it's been like a month since I moved in, but I got most of the larger items before I even moved in. So like my bed, TV console, things like that, that were not like essential, but things that were going to take a little bit more time to build. I've got all of that stuff before I moved in, and I'm at the point now where I've gotten all of the bigger items, and now it's just more so time to decorate. As you can see, all of the walls are still very plain and barren, so we need to spice those walls up. Not, unfortunately, what I'm going to be talking about in today's video. However, I did stop at the Motherland recently, HomeGoods is a go-to place for all your home decor, even some furniture, rugs, things like that. Wonderful place, especially right now. I did find out that because of COVID, HomeGoods and TJ Maxx, Ross, Marshalls, all of their buyers now are buying from from like Macy's, Bed Bath & Beyond, places like that, because they're having huge buyout sales. So like these bigger places like Macy's and Bed Bath & Beyond are having these huge buyout sales. Buyers from Home Goods, all of those places, they're coming in, buying out all of these really amazing products, and they're bringing them to Home Goods for an absolute amazing price. So today I have 6 items, I believe, to share with you that I picked up from Home Goods recently. Would you believe that after I show you guys everything, I'm gonna tell you guys the total right now was $125, $124, somewhere around there. Maybe it was even lower. It was like $121. I did check my bank statement then, and I'm pretty sure it was like $121 actually. But still, around that price range for 6 home decor items, and just wait until you see these items. Now, I've been searching for home decor online from places like Pottery Barn, Wayfair, Overstock, West Elm. I know that's like on the more expensive side, but literally just searching high and low for different home decor items. And you know, honestly, the prices that I've kind of become accustomed to through doing my research online already are uncomparable. They are not even comparable whatsoever to the prices that I found at Home Goods recently. So without further ado, let's just get right into this haul. I also did post this haul on my IGTV, so if you have not seen that, it's the exact same thing, but you can head over there on my Instagram. And I also did do some research and found as many dupes of these items as possible. I know with HomeGoods you can't link exact items, obviously, because they don't have an online shop, but I did find as many dupes for you guys as possible and did link those for you guys. So if you are unable to find these at HomeGoods, you can always head to the description box below, check out those dupes there. And also my Instagram and other handles are always linked down there as well, so you can always check those out too. The first item that I picked up is this little serving tray. It's like a flat serving tray. It's wicker, and it's this really nice black and white detail. So what my whole purpose for buying this was, I was really looking to decorate my little shelving unit I had in my bathroom above the toilet. And I figured this would look really nice, like propped up flat like this against the shelving unit on the top shelf and add just a really nice decor piece to the overall look. My bathroom, I went for a very plain, minimal black and white with beige accents kind of look. So I want it to be very calm and peaceful and kind of give like a spa feel. So I went with this to add some kind of like dimension and cool, like a cool twist to the bathroom, but it also fits in very well. So this was a great find. I do not unfortunately have the prices of anything anymore, but this was extremely cheap. Also for the bathroom, the next two items are going to be for the bathroom shelving unit as well. But I had wanted to purchase things to hold like little hand towels and my toilet paper, but like make it look cute and everything. So I wanted to put those things on the shelving unit, didn't really know what to do. But I found a bunch of these little boxes at Home Goods and I fell in love with this one. I love the wood on this, the actual like shade of wood and then the detailing on the top. And this box actually opens. Obviously, they're probably meant for, they can be used for decor, but they're probably meant to be used for like, I don't know, like a memory box or something like that. However, my envision with this was to prop it open like this up against the shelving unit and then place the hand towels in there. But after actually styling it and using it, I decided to leave it closed like this and just roll up the towels really nice and place them on like a, or place them like a pyramid on top so that you could still see the pretty detailing of the box. But the hand towels look so cute on there and I love the way that I ended up, or how I ended up decorating the hand towels and like the shelving unit overall. It's probably like one of my favorite things I've done so far. This was $12.99 though, and they had so many different sizes and shapes of these. So I did try linking one similar box that I found, which you could find on the links in the description box. And then lastly for that shelving unit, I found this really nice wicker basket with a really nice wood color to it. I wanted, again, this was the whole idea with the hand towels and, or not hand towels, I've been saying hand towels, washcloths. For the washcloths, and this one I wanted to get for toilet paper. So I stacked this on the bottom shelf and then put three rolls of toilet paper in a pyramid on here. It looks super, like, it makes the toilet paper look more fashionable. So I would definitely recommend things like this to help dress up a bathroom where it's just like toilet paper, washcloths, like towels, like even if you had extra towels. Unfortunately, my bathroom's not big enough for me to put my extra towels there, so I have them in my closet. But even finding a nice big wicker basket like this and putting your extra towels in on the ground just adds a little something to it to dress up the whole entire place. I do believe this was $9.99, if I'm not mistaken, or maybe even cheaper. I'm pretty sure it was $9.99 because I found almost identical ones at the Container Store, which I did link for you guys below. They are also still very cheap, but the one that I was looking for toilet paper was $12.99 versus this was $9.99. So just a few dollars difference, but it really does make the difference. And why not get the cheaper option if you can? Another item that I had been looking for such a long time for in my kitchen was just a decorative bowl for fruits and vegetables that I leave out. I had an old basket, it was a wire basket that I used in previous apartments for books. I didn't find a purpose here, so I just decided to use that for the meantime. However, I did find literally the perfect bowl that I'm so excited about because it's so similar to ones that I had been looking at previously that costed a lot more than this one did. So I found this really pretty light wood bowl. It's massive and you could use this as like a catch-all bowl or just as a decorative bowl. You could put like decorative little I don't know, what's that stuff that like smells good? I really don't know. But it's like that decorative stuff that smells really good. You could put that in here, or even like some cool decorative like bowls, especially around the holiday time. Like you could decorate this with Christmas bowls. Like there's just like endless options for what you can do in here. So I decided to put this in the corner of my kitchen, actually. Where is it? Over here on this corner here. And I just put like bananas, onions, things like that in here that I leave out. And this was, oh my gosh, I took the price tag off. It was like unreal. It was probably around $12.99, I think. It was on sale and it was like double the sale. And I think it was $12.99, if I'm not mistaken. So, really amazing find, and you can find so many different decorative bowls or serving trays at Home Goods in general. So this next piece is actually something that I stood in the store, I saw it, was amazed by it, needed it, but I stood in the store for so long trying to think of where I could put this and how I could decorate with this. But I couldn't pass it up because the whole vibe of my apartment is very like neutral. It obviously, as you can tell so far, neutral boat. It's like a neutral mid-century modern vibe with like a touch of boho to it. So this would be my touch of boho, just adding like pampas grass or dried palm leaves. That's adding like a touch of boho, and that is like my style. Super simple, but always like having some sort of boho twist to it. So I love this. It's just dried palm leaves stitched into this like whole woodwork detailing, like little decorative object. But for right now, I might place it somewhere else later on as I continue to decorate and fill up my apartment. But right now I have it placed over in this corner over here that you guys can't see, but it's where my huge full length mirror is. I have it placed in the corner just as like a little decorative object to have over there. So that's where I decided to put this. I believe, oh, this was $18. So for a decorative object like this, honestly, really great find and really great price point. The last two items I'm going to show you are vases. Vases, for me, let me just tell you, are the hardest thing to find for a good price. And I'm talking like good price for me before was $30 to $70. It depends on like how large the vase is, but I was looking every single place for different vases that matched my whole vibe and aesthetic. Some of them were either way too expensive or they were just way too plain. And I mean, my apartment is already very neutral and plain to begin with. The pieces that I'm trying to decorate with, I want to be neutral and fit in, but I want them to have something to them to add something like a little bit of pizzazz to the apartment. Like I want the pieces, the decorative pieces, to pull the apartment together. And like make it not so plain and boring, if that makes sense. So, really amazing find. I was just at Home Goods the other day too, and I found even more of these little vases, or they're big vases, never mind. But it's this huge, like literally half the size of me, vase here, and it's this blue toned glass. Which I really, really, it's more like a green toned glass actually, but super pretty. I was a little skeptical that it wouldn't go with the vibe of my apartment, but since it's so plain and neutral, I haven't gotten it yet, but I plan to get more pampas grass to put in this vase. And I also have this vase paired over where my full length mirror is in the corner. So I love where it's at. I love where it's located right now. But I think I need to get more pampas grass, put that in there, and it will definitely pull the whole look together. But loved this piece, and I'm pretty sure this was $18, or no, this one was $19.99, so amazing, amazing price for a glass vase that is literally half the size of me. Can't beat it. Last but not least, probably another favorite find of mine, was this little vase right here. This vase is perfect. It is like the whole vibe I'm going for with the vases that I pick, because it's super neutral, but the actual detailing gives it a little flair that makes it more decorative and less plain. So again, I can't stress it enough. That's what I'm going for with the decor, is just like neutral, but it has something to it that makes it less plain and boring. So this is more so, it kind of looks like a whitewashed wood design with like these ridge detailings, but it's not really wood, it's actually ceramic. So yeah, I really love this a lot. I've decided to place this on my TV console for right now. I have a vase over here with pampas grass in it on one side, and then I decided to place this on the actual top of the console to kind of like offset and fill in that like little white space right there. So I decided to put this there and I absolutely love it, and it was an amazing find. Also, I do have the price on here. This was the most expensive item I purchased, and it was only $24.99, and for a vase, still, that's a really great price, and I would pay that. So although it was the most expensive, it's still a really affordable price for something like this. So that is actually it for the haul. I actually ended up having 7 pieces. I forgot about that last base there, but amazing finds. I will continue to go back to Home Goods for a very long time, because I obviously still have a ways to go with decorating my apartment. And it's just nice to find like little trinkets there to decorate small spaces, or even like vases, finding vases there, that's really amazing. Or right now, what I'm more so in the market for is finding artwork to place over my bed right here. As you can see, the ceilings in this place are so tall that it would look a little ridiculous to have pretty small artwork over here. So I really need to find something that's like not going to be too big and dramatic, but going to fill the space and make it look more put together and less like bare. So that is what I'm in the market for right now, and I'm just searching high and low at all Home Goods to find really cheap artwork. If not, I do have in mind 2 different art prints that I'm probably going to get and place here and just get them printed very large and put them in black frames, but we'll see. I don't know exactly if I'm going to do that yet or not, but that's also just a super affordable way to decorate a space as well. Just go on Etsy, look up art prints. You could get them printed out at Staples or somewhere like that, and then buy extremely affordable frames from like Michaels or Amazon or somewhere like that. So that is it for today's haul. I hope you guys enjoyed, and let me know if you find any of these pieces at Home Goods. Definitely get to Home Goods ASAP, or just whenever you can, because it is an absolute dream of a place. It is my dream home, actually. Like, if I could live anywhere, I would live in Home Goods. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video and are excited for more styling and apartment decor related blogs or videos, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe if you aren't already. I will see you guys next time.